life of youth. Let us all welcome Shri.H. Tovihoto Ayemi ji with a big round of applause.
Today's program, the convener of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose birth anniversary of Dimapur, Nagaland, Shri Biplab Paul ji, Shri KK Paul, the president of Bengali Samaj Dimapur and Nagaland, engineer Dr. Vikho Yesu Suro, the prominent leader of Seva Samiti, Sri Gopal Sharma ji, the president of Bihari Samaj Dimapur, Sri Yoginder Gupta, a most prominent leader, Sri Hure Jelian, principal of the Bharati Vidya, Vidya Bharati, Nagaland. The committee of Durgabari Chateswari colony, the dignitaries present, I'm sorry I could not mention all of your names, the invitees, the guests, Nagaland state BJP spokesperson Mr. Pintu Ghosh. My dear media friends, my beloved brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen present this evening. I am so happy and I want to thank the committee for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this 125th birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. I bring greetings to all the dignitaries present this evening on this occasion. We are all aware of the fact that and 85 panel members headed by our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji has been formed earlier to commemorate the 125th birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. And as been mentioned by some of the former speakers, this 23rd January is going to be the Parakaram Diwas. It's also explained by our chairperson of today's program. Parakaram Diwas is the day of courage and valor. Every year it's going to be celebrated in a very befitting manner at a national level and also the international level. And this year particularly, there's going to be a year-long celebration, programs, different activities in all parts of the country, every nook and corner of the country. Some of you have mentioned so many things about Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, who was born on 23rd January 1897 till 1945. So I'm just thinking, if I have to repeat or skip and then go to some of the important events that has taken place during his lifetime as a freedom fighter, the iconic leader of India. We all know that he was so very brilliant student during his early days. He has come from a very prominent and an influential family whose father was a very eminent lawyer at that point of time, also from a very wealthy family from West Bengal, which was, he was born in Katak, of course was the Orissa division of West Bengal province. Then later on he was pressurized maybe by the family members to go and write an Indian civil service. So he left for London, appeared for their exams, came out successfully, but 1920, with the demand of the national movement in India, and at some point of time maybe he thought that he may have to side with the British government. So he gave up his job and came back to India. During his youthful days, he joined the party, Congress Party. He was also the president of Indian Youth Congress. Later on, he was also working with one of the newspapers in Calcutta. Later, after a year or so, he opened his own press, name of Swaraj. Then later, during 1920 to 1934, he wrote a book. See, here what I want to tell all of us, or remind all of us, of course we do know who Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was. He was an educator, he was a journalist, he was a writer, he was a politician, he was a commander, he was a military man. He's that personality that India have had of the centuries. Then he became the president of the Indian National Congress. Maybe even for the second term, he was elected as the president of Indian National Congress during 1939. But because of certain reason, he has to resign from the party. Then after, he has never rejoined this party. During his youthful days, he has been arrested several times. At one point of time, he was arrested and then sent to Burma, now the Myanmar. And his struggle and his selfless services and his sacrifices for the Indian National Movement is undoubtedly unmatched, unparalleled to any of the personalities of those time in India. But why? Our Gopal Samaji has also mentioned why Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was not given a due recognition all these years. I will just jump here and there, but those days politicians, Gandhi, Nehru and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, those days the politicians, yes, political differences could be there, the differences of opinion was surely there, but the one quality of those days politicians, I'm going to tell you, is they were so very magnanimous. Gandhiji pronounced that Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was or is the prince of the patriots, and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in Singapore during 1943 has declared Mahatma Gandhi as the father of nation. Yes, they had some little differences, opinion in politics. Thakise, holy be, iniga manu thakise, duta bilaga. But after India's freedom, after India was liberated from the British empire or the British regime, till then, for so many years, Gandhiji, somewhere or the other, has been kept sidelined, not given that due recognition which he deserves. He made India proud. His deeds and his activities and his involvement for the Free India Movement was never celebrated like this of 2021, January 23rd. So many places have. Yesterday, as mentioned, our Honorable Prime Minister was in Calcutta celebrating the 125th year of Netaji, also declaring Parakram Diwas, which will be celebrated every year from today onwards. Such a huge honor for Netaji was never witnessed in India prior to this government, NDA, BJP-led government, under the able leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji. Not to mention of anybody, any name, any party, but this platform and this due recognition was never there. But we are all very happy. Bishi khushi ase. Aji din bar loi gana. Every year, this Parakram Diwas will be celebrated. We all need to admit the fact. I should also acknowledge this very fact that the earlier regimes, earlier government, successive governments has not done what I have already said. We have also witnessed the days before this nation celebrates the 125th year celebration, the Howrah Kalka Mail is also been renamed as Netaji Express. It's a great matter of it's a matter of great pride for all of us today. In fact, Netaji's Parakram has put India on the express route of freedom and development. But we all need to celebrate every moment of this great son of India. In us, his great qualities. Kunba inega আমগান জানি থাকা আর রিমাইন্ড না জেনে একটা দুই দিন আমি কব So then after his resignation as the president of Indian INC, he was put under house arrest by the British government. Now he made a plan, escape route, then probably he went he went to Lahore and then Afghanistan, then to reach Russia, then USSR, Soviet Union. There he came for some time and had a contact with the Nazis in Germany. Reached Berlin and had a appointments with the Führer, Adolf Hitler. So one quality here I want to mention. Met Adolf Hitler and spoke to him about the state or the conditions of India. That point of time in his autobiography called Mein Kampf. In his autobiography Mein Kampf, there was some derogatory sentence or words mentioned about in India. So we can all imagine 1940, 41, 42, 43, 44, that point of time, who was Adolf Hitler? He is such a ferocious leader, the dictator. He had that formidable force, his armies, his technologies. Netaji Chandra Bose, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, taiki log paisi do, aro koise, enega ase, amakhan apna laga madot lage. Aro tai laga auto biography de bi, tai koise, itu India laga, junto alop সুন্দর নাই এইটো তো আপনার বায়োগ্রাফির পর হাতাই দিব লাগিব হাউ বোল্ড হি ওয়াজ ইন সামওয়ানস নেশন উইথ দ্যাট দ্যাট কাইন্ড অফ এ লিডার হি ইজ টকিং টু সো উই শুড একনোলেজ হিজ গাটস এন্ড দ্য বোল্ড দ্যাট ব্রেভারি ইন হিম আডলফ হিটলার কইছে তো 36 million population of India, that point of time. Now that we have 1.3 billion population, but that point of time, about 36 crores population, with a handful of British living in India, ruling India, handful means in thousands. Itu tu India tu itu tu kita pun hobo. এনেকা লাগে মেনশন করিয়ে নাছো তো কিন্তু তাই লাগে হিমত চাবি তো কই না তার লগত ইন্টারেক্ট করেছে বাট অন এ প্র্যাকটিক্যাল নোট অ্যাডলফ হিটলার সেড আই এম রেডি টু হেল্প ইউ আউট বাট মাই আর্মি অ্যান্ড মাই মেশিনারিজ অ্যান্ড মাই পিপল রিচিং ইন্ডিয়া অ্যালং উইথ ইউ may take years together, 1-2 years. So he has fixed some connection with the Imperial Army of Japan. And Hitler himself has arranged Germany's submarine and put him there and then sent to Japan. Maybe on in between Netaji, you know, boarded that submarine and then again Japanese submarine proposition again. He stayed there for almost in Germany for almost 2-3 years time. Then he was broadcasting in a radio called Azad Hind Radio in so many different languages, English, Hindi, Bengali, Gujarati, then in so many languages, some 7-8 languages, talking to the Indian, because that was, radio is supposed to be the only communication at that point of time. See here, why I'm mentioning all this is, the amount of time and energy and then the brain, and then the idea, idealism that he possessed, and then the determination to free India, he has reached out to these many countries and these many leaders to seek assistance to liberate India from the British regime. Now, after reaching Japan, Japanese thought that he is not militarily skilled, but of course he has already formed the INA, Azad Hind Fauj, Indian National Army, INA. And then from there they have decided to reach India with the slogan Delhi Chalo. So it took how many months to reach, but Germany, Japan, Burma, Italy, Singapore, so many countries have supported the movement of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose is also very dear to all of us. The entire country celebrates his birthday today and will be celebrating and will be remembering his bravery and courage, and then he was the hero. He was the real patriot of the Indian movement. And some of you have mentioned about Nagaland, the earlier speakers. Then they started the journey to India via Myanmar, Burma, now Myanmar, and to Manipur, Jasami, and Peck, and the person is sitting here with us, Engineer Dr. Veko Suro. His village, the Ruzazu village. Nagas are also very fond of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. He reached Nagaland, Peck, and Ruzazu village. Yes, there was a time where there were no historians, no writers, no researchers, but now things are coming out, as our president Bangali Samaj, Sri K. Kapoor, has mentioned. The truth cannot be hidden. Husa laga jinis tu kita bhi bond kuri rakhibo na paro, it will come out with time, so it is coming out. At that point of time in Nagaland has no such historians or researchers like that, but our engineer doctor has already written a book, one book, there Netaji reached and asked for, and he was received by the people. He called a meeting and ask for any educated person in the village, because now they have to communicate to Nagamis, to Nagamis kobuna Hindi kobuna English kobuna to manu to lagye. Then the person in the name of Pasawi Suro, our doctor's father, who is still alive, is he in the village? So among the villagers, he was one who could communicate with the Subhash Babu and his army, Ayemi. Then the villagers fetched water for them, collected firewood for them, brought food, all the survival items were arranged and managed by the villagers and was given to Netaji and his army. Stayed there, Netaji displayed his arms and his people and all the things that he has brought all the way. Somewhere I've read that he came in a horse with a sword, long sword, and two grenade and a pistol he was carrying. Then that point of that was 1944, 4th April. He reached Nagaland, camped in that village and nearby village, nearby villages also. Then from Zula, he took his contingent to Zula and then to Kilomi village and Sataka. But upon hearing that the British army were stationed in Zinepoto, they had to retreat. This is what I learned, but these are the facts. And the villagers were so inspired, and the Nagas were also inspired by the movement and by the, you know, initiative that Chandra Bose was undertaking. And I did not want to dwell much. There was a Kohima battle, we all know. Maybe for some logistic support, because air access was there with the Britishers, but it was not there with the Netaji and INA. Somehow they have reached, but that supply and then communication and then that you know, accessibility with so many things. So then they have to retreat and then go back. Some of you have also mentioned about the mystery of his death. Some said he died in a plane crash, the third degree burn, the flight of Taipei. Some said as per the INS soldiers' version. Some said he did not die, but as already been explained by our former speakers, who might have gone detail in depth study of the Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. But all what I want to say here is the Naga people, the Nagas, still recognize the leadership of our great leader, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. The entire country still remembers. He is not only the leader of that particular area or that particular community or that particular region, but Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was the freedom fighter and then the real patriot of Indian independence. There are so many things we can learn from Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Gandhi and Nehru started the civil disobedience movement and then non-violence, but Britishers were watching what will be the reaction of the entire population of India at that point of time. But once this INA was formed and led by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, then Britishers, the British Empire was shaken. And they then started a plan to retreat after the so many years of aggression and ruling India. Subhash Chandra Bose is the youth icon of today. As I said, his birth anniversary should be celebrated, and we should be celebrating his Parakram Diwas in a befitting manner, not only today. I still remember early 2000, I have attended the birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in one of the Netaji club in Railway Colony. Some of you are still here around, some of the members are no more, but it is always so dear to me. I have also hoisted the flags in the Netaji club. We used to have a very small program, small gathering, you know. And it has been continued, but for some time, to be very honest, maybe the club members or the elders here in Dimapur have also stopped doing that. And it's been just few years now, 4 or 5 years, this we have started, but now that with this Parakram Diwas, all India will be celebrating the birth anniversary of our great leader, Shri Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. He was the reason why India could come together. He traveled breadth and length of the country, of the nation, not leaving aside any part of the nation. Not undermining or sidelining any part of the region or any part of the community, any part. If I just want to remind all of us, if we still remember, he had a brigade in INA called Rani Lakshmi by brigade. I think there was also a brigade of Nehru brigade and Gandhi brigade, if I'm not mistaken. The first Mahila, Aji Lava Kutha Kobolya, Mahila Battalion. Yeah. So, this is how he brought India together. With so much of slogan, I've been hearing continuously, Mujhe khun do, aur main aapko azad dunga. Give me blood, and I shall give you freedom. And that Delhi Chalo, and then the famous slogan, even today, the Jai Hind. With these few words, I want to thank the organizers, particularly the members of this committee, led by the convener, Mr. Biplab Paulji, and all the advisors and all the people involved, for giving me this opportunity to share few of my thoughts. History at times people may try to rewrite, at times people may try to twist, but the history will always remain. And with this iconic personality of India, we shall always try to unite together. In unity, everything is possible. When there is a unison and when there is a unity among ourselves, we can achieve so many things. So he is one pride for all of us. He should be one reason for all of us to come together, unite. And there are a lot of things that youth of today can do. And he is always an inspirational, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So in the end, let us not only celebrate his 125th birth anniversary, but also bear his great personality in our lives and devote ourselves for the nation building. And it was for this great nation, Subhash Chandra Bose and other distinguished leaders laid down their lives. So let us all live up to the expectations. Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!